In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to optimize Calibre FastXOR rule generation. By simply providing the GDS or OASIS input file names and the output rule file name, I can generate an XOR deck that I can use to run Calibre. Many Calibre users realize that they can run DBdiff to generate XOR rules. Those rules can be used in either FastXOR or traditional XOR jobs. While these basic settings are fine for some jobs, it's not optimized. One basic optimization recommended for all Calibre SVRF decks is to include the layout base layer statements. Defining the base layers in an SVRF deck helps Calibre build good hierarchy and optimize overall performance. This part of the rule generation can't be automated because we don't know what the base layer numbers are for every design. Although the layer numbers differ, the objects they represent are the same. We recommend using device creation layers as the base layer inputs. In this example, I can pretty quickly find the diffusion layer, the contact layer, and the poly layer. With that information, I can go back and regenerate the XOR rules using DBdiff, but I'll add the dash base layers command line option. With this option set, I'll provide the input GDS layer number and data type for all of my base layers that I found in the layout. This deck is now optimized for better hierarchy creation and should improve our overall performance. Comparing the runtime of this optimized deck versus the previous run I did, you can see that there was a small improvement. With larger designs, the improvement can be much greater. If you're running FastXOR through the Calibre Interactive GUI, you can also set the layout base layer statement through there. First, I'll set my current and reference design inputs. Enable XOR rule generation by clicking on the Create XOR Rules button here. And then in the mapping files section, you can choose base layers and then define the base layers as we've done on the command line. Now I'll click Run DRC to start the job. And if I scroll back up to the top of the transcript, you can actually see the base layer statement that was used during rule generation. I hope you found this helpful. Thanks for watching.